have four occupations for you. Deirdre, you are a sewage diver. Richard, you're the Queen's bagpiper. David, you're an ornamental hermit. And Alan, you're bailiff of the Chiltern Hundreds. Which of you has got a real job?
The Chiltern Hundreds is a real place.
Yes, but is the job a real job?
It's an empty job. It's what you get when you resign as an MP. Join the Chiltern Hundreds.
So it's not really a real job. So 1624, they passed a law saying that nobody can leave Parliament. And it stems from the time when people were elected against their will. So sometimes local gentry were made to join Parliament. They didn't really want to. And the law says technically you have to die or you have to be voted out or you have to go and work for the Queen or something. So if you want to retire, you apply for a fictional Crown office called the Steward and Bailiff of the Chiltern Hundreds. And here are some people who have, in their time,
look at
stewards.
Tony Blair pretending to drink wine.
He brought an empty glass to his lips and now he has filled it with his special liquid. Then he passes it to the person next to him, they drink it, and then they like him.
So let's go back to the sewage diver. What do you reckon? Did it a real job?
Well, it's a shit job, isn't it?
It is the look at that. It is a real thing.
It's so they have wading, they do.
There you go,
diving.
Yeah.
But that's not a way to resign if you're an MP. So I think that would be quite popular.
That would be a good way.
I wish to leave politics, so now I will immerse myself in excrement.
Yes.
Hooray!
Who would do this job?
I used to be a sewage diver. It was just going through the motions.
There are sewage farms and they have sort of moving parts and when things get stuck, they're fitted with air pipelines, they have to dive in and climb down to fix them.
Oh, God.
Fitted with air pipelines, I would hope so.
Yes, I just take a deep breath and go for it. I would have thought the worst job is the person who has to clean the suit when they get out.
I don't know. I think I'd go presented with that.
Yeah.
Terrible career choice. I think I'd go for cleaning the suit.
What about you, Queen's bagpiper, Richard? Is that a real job?
Well, she's got everything, hasn't she? The Queen. So, yeah, gosh, I'd imagine so.
She is really keen on bagpipers, isn't
well,
she?
Well, she inherited it. Queen Victoria was terribly keen. I mean, mad keen. Yeah.
Mad for the bagpipes.
Yeah. There was no telly then, so, you know, fair enough.
It was much easier in the days when all you had to be better than was a bagpiper.
Yeah. 9 o'clock every morning, he plays for 15 minutes underneath her window.
Oh, no, he doesn't.
Well, he's been told it's her window. Who knows where she is. They play 15 minutes every day at Buckingham Palace, Windsor Castle, Balmoral or Holyrood House. They don't play at Sandringham. Anybody know why?
Because she needs a break. That's the Christmas one, isn't it, Sandringham?
Yeah. Well, apparently it's because there isn't enough accommodation.
Sorry, we just don't have the room for the bagpiper.
One of the things they say...
It's a kind of anti the Christmas story, is it?
Very unstable.
He's a page of presents, but I have no idea what that is.
A page of presents is Santa's list, isn't it?
I'm going to give you an extra point because that's the cutest answer anybody's ever given. What about the ornamental hermit, David? What do you reckon?
I think, didn't the sort of very rich, mad aristocrat that built Follies might think a folly would be even more fun if it was permanently inhabited by someone employed to sort of be there and be
a
hermit.
You're absolutely right. It was very fashionable in the 18th century and they liked people to sort of dress up as druids and they lived in caves. If the landowner couldn't afford a hermit, because, you know, they're pricey, they saved money by having just the hermitage and telling everybody the hermit was out. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.